नमस्ते बच्चों, लेट अस स्टार्ट आवर न्यू क्लास टुडे। एंड हियर इन दिस क्लास वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द कंपैरिजन ऑफ प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ सॉल्यूशन, सस्पेंशन एंड क्लोराइड। इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस्ड इंडिविजुअली सॉल्यूशन, क्लोराइड एंड सस्पेंशन। हियर वी विल कंपेयर देयर प्रॉपर्टीज, ओके। एंड आफ्टर दैट वी विल डिस्कस वन method of separation of mixture also, okay. See, first of all we'll discuss about the nature of mixture. See, solution is homogeneous in nature, colloid is heterogeneous. Although it seems to be homogeneous, but it is heterogeneous, and suspension is heterogeneous, okay. This is about the nature of the mixture. Second is particle size. The particles of solution are smallest in size, that is they are less than 1 nanometer. Then the particle of suspensor are clad, their size are 10 to the power minus 6 meter to 10 to the power minus 9 meter approx, and the suspension particle size are 10 to the power minus 5 to 10 to the power minus 7 2. See, and the size of suspension particles are 10 to the power minus 5 meter to 10 to the power minus 7 meter. Here I want to say that the particle size of solution are the smallest and size of particles of suspension are the biggest, okay. Here the range is given. Actually we cannot find the actual size, the range is given here only, okay. Third point is visibility. Particles of solutions either cannot be seen by the naked eye or nor under microscope. Means the particles of solution are very very small in size and they cannot be seen either with the using of microscope or the naked eyes, okay. Colloidal particle size are a little bit bigger than the solution particle, but they cannot be seen by the naked eye. Yes, under ultra microscope they can be observed as white spot, means we can find them under ultra microscope. And suspension particles are clearly seen by our naked eyes, okay. Tyndall effect, it is also called scattering of light. This effect is due to the scattering of light, means in this effect the path of light is visible through the mixture. So in solution, solution does not show Tyndall effect, because Tyndall effect is due to the size of the particles of the mixture. Since the size of solution particle is very small, so it doesn't show Tyndall effect. But colloid and suspension both shows Tyndall effect, okay, because the particle size of colloid and suspension are bigger than that of solution, okay. Now the next, stability. Solution is stable, colloid is also stable, but suspension is not stable. See, solution is stable, it means if we'll keep a sample of solution on a surface without any disturbance for few hours, the components will not be separated at all, means it will be stable. Same condition is there in the case of colloid, but suspension is unstable, okay. Usme kya hoga ki jo components hai wo niche baith jayenge, ठीक है. नेक्स्ट प्रॉपर्टी इज फिल्टरेशन. See, the Sunshine particles are very small in size, so they can pass through filter paper. It means the components of solution cannot be separated with the help of process filtration. Colloidal particle too pass through the filter paper, and they also cannot be separated with the help of filtration process. Okay, but suspended particles are separated through the filter paper. Okay, so this is all about the comparison. We have compared six properties: nature, particle size, visibility, Tyndall effect, stability, and filtration. Now we'll talk about one method of separation of mixture. See, as we have discussed that these all are the mixtures, and in these mixtures there are some methods to separate the components. In some mixture it is very easy for us to separate, like pebbles in rice, husk from grain. We separate easily by using very common method, but in some special cases we need some special methods for separation. Okay, here we'll separate a colored component from blue or black ink. See, the pen which I am writing with, this pen or also others contain some ink. It means ink is mixed in water. So we have to separate here the ink from water. So what we'll do, we'll use a method. It is named as evaporation. Evaporation method is used here for separation. See what we'll do for that. For that we'll take a beaker which contains almost half filled with water. A watch glass is kept on beaker, and this watch glass contain the ink, okay, from which we have to separate water from the dye. And see here, a burner is taken. It is a burner and it is a stand. Now we'll keep a beaker on a stand instead of the burner, and it is filled with half water. Now a watch glass is kept on the beaker and it contains ink. See, now we'll start heating. We'll see that when water gets heated, the heat from this goes to the watch glass, and watch glass also starts heating slowly. Okay, and what we'll observe, that vapors from this also starts to come out. Okay, now we'll continue the heating. And we'll see after some time, now there will be no vaporization. Means the water present in this mixture is completely removed off. Now we'll stop heating. And what we will observe? We will observe that there is some blue or black, whatever ink we have taken, that dye is remain left in the watch glass. So by this method, means by evaporation, we have separated water from the dye. See, one question arises, why have we not heated this mixture directly on the burner? See, the reason behind it is that it will not be a gentle heating. If we'll heat this watch glass directly in this burner, it will not be a gentle heating, and it may burn the dye or color. Okay, so for gentle heating, we applied this process. We kept this watch glass on the beaker containing water, and we see slowly, slowly the water vaporizes and dry remain left. So it is a method called evaporation from which through which we have separated dye from water. So there are so many methods, we'll see one by one in the next class. Today we have discussed about the comparison and one method of separation of component of mixture. Thank you.